When it comes to evolution, for most living creatures, it's a matter of survival or extinction. Especially for large land animals, where competition is fierce, there's no room for slack. Any moment of weakness could mean the end. But there's one group of large mammals that seem to be playing the evolutionary game like a casual blind box unboxing. Most of their evolution feels like rolling the dice, yet they somehow always find the perfect winning combo. That group is the even-toed ungulates. Today, most animals with hooves belong to this big family, including the pigs, cows, and sheep we see all the time. They're basically humanity's tastiest friends. But the diversity of even-toed ungulates goes way beyond just the steaks and bacon on your plate. Some scientists now suggest calling them Cetartiodactyla. Remember I mentioned before that the ancestor of whales, Indohus, had hooves on its feet? Yup, whales are actually a branch of the even-toed ungulates too. The story of this little deer-like animal evolving all the way into a blue whale is wild. You can check out my other video on that. Think about it. These guys managed to totally reinvent themselves into fish-like creatures. That's some next-level evolutionary madness. The ancestors of even-toed ungulates were probably small animals similar to Diacodexis. They had digging claws and a well-developed gut. This combo likely gave them a versatile diet. So shortly after the massive asteroid hit 66 million years ago, even-toed ungulates rapidly rose up, spreading throughout the shattered forests of the Northern Hemisphere. As life bounced back, the omnivore niche got super crowded. Around 55.5 million years ago, during the Paleocene-Eocene thermal maximum, the world's forests connected into vast green belts. Survivors had to switch into eat-or-be-eaten mode. Still, one group of even-toed ungulates thrived in the omnivore niche, the Suina. Suina had their own secret weapon, their snouts and huge nasal cavities. They evolved the most diverse set of olfactory receptors of any land mammal, giving them top-tier smell powers. Combine that with their curved tusks, and they could root out underground fungi or insects hiding in tree holes like pros. But no matter how they evolved, even-toed ungulates always had one thing on their minds: fighting. Suina are no exception. About 100,000 years ago, Cubanocoerus grew a bony spike on its head. With a body weight up to half a ton, it must have caused some serious clashes. So yeah, even though they're omnivores, Suina are tough characters. Today's wild boars prove it. They can even eat cacti like North America's Taya Suidae. Besides that, there's Sus philippensis with their stylish hair and Sus barbatus with their flowing beards. But in my opinion, the most hardcore is Babyrousa. Male Babyrousa grow two pairs of tusks. One pair sticks out from the mouth like normal, but the other pair grows backward inside the mouth, then pierces through the cheek and keeps growing in front of their eyes until it punctures their skull. That's some brutal self-harm level crazy. Seeing their wild pig relatives like this, some even-toed ungulates thought, "Hey, I can do that too." About 40 million years ago, somewhere between Mongolia and Yunnan in China, a new even-toed ungulate appeared called Entelodontidae. At first, their lifestyle wasn't too different from wild pigs, but soon their bones became weird and wild, and their faces rough. For example, Entelodon in Eurasia and Archaeotherium in North America had big heads covered in jagged bony protrusions with massive muscle attachments. In contrast, their brains were surprisingly small. With muscles everywhere, these big-brained bros had insanely strong bites. Some studies show their jaws could open up to 109 degrees. As they evolved, they ate more meat. Around 20 million years ago, Diacodon's habitat was littered with bones chewed up by them. Still, until Entelodontidae went extinct around 16 million years ago, they were basically omnivores who occasionally hunted or scavenged. their terrifying mouths mainly served as weapons for fighting each other, just like their relatives, the hippos, do today. Since meat alone couldn't save the even-toed ungulates, they had to turn to plants. Around 34 million years ago, the global climate suddenly cooled.
Winter is coming.
After millions of years of lush rainforests, the world entered a grassier era. Grass is tougher and harder to digest than leaves, which spelled disaster for many plant eaters, causing a major extinction event between the Eocene and Oligocene. After this extinction, durable high-crowned teeth became standard for grazers. This led to the rise of large animals like the odd-toed ungulates and proboscideans. But even-toed ungulates took a different route. They evolved a unique survival skill, rumination. Simply put, their esophagus developed chambers full of helpful microbes, allowing them to gulp down rough grass, partially digest it, then regurgitate and chew it again. For example, about 30 million years ago in North America, a group called Tylopoda used this trick to rapidly dominate the grasslands. Today, only camels and alpacas remain from this group, but historically they were very diverse and occupied many niches. Early ones like the small, hopping Canotherium could be thought of as camel versions of rabbits. Others looked like camel pigs, camel hippos, and camel donkeys. By about 20 million years ago, Tylopoda started to look more like modern camels. Abicamelus even had a long neck, resembling a camel giraffe. Or giraffe camel, if you will. This led to a bunch of big camels like Megacamelus and Titanotylopus, reaching heights up to 3.5 meters. Their descendants crossed the Bering Strait and perfected the camel hump, a fat storage that produces water and energy through metabolism, helping them survive in dry deserts and steppes. Unfortunately, camels and alpacas never quite dominated the lushest grasslands. That honor went to another group of even-toed ungulates who took rumination to the extreme. The Ruminantia, including deer, cattle, and sheep. They evolved three extra stomach chambers, the rumen, reticulum, and omasum, with folded walls to increase microbial contact with plant material. Rumination not only protects their teeth from wear, but lets them swallow large amounts of grass quickly, then chew it safely later, great for avoiding predators during feeding. With this advantage, even-toed ungulates could finally focus on fighting again. Take the Giraffidae family, for example. Is this really worthy of being called giraffes? It's obviously short-necked giraffes. Although this family was once glorious, today the only short-necked giraffe still living among us is just one species, the okapi. But this family still loves to cause trouble. Even early giraffe ancestors headbutted each other, turning their skulls into living flails. The longer the neck, the stronger the hit. Eventually, they found a bonus. Long necks make it easier to reach tree leaves, and so the modern giraffe was born. Other ruminants share the same rough spirit. Small ones like Mushidae and Hydropotes have sharp, saber-like teeth that could shame carnivores. Bigger ruminants put their skill points into horns. Today's species have horns that are thick, forked, straight, curved, or spiraled. And history had even stranger ones like Synthetocheras, which had bizarre forked noses. It's like all the calcium saved from teeth went straight into making these flashy horns. Some deer even suffer seasonal osteoporosis from growing antlers, and chew off their shed antlers afterward to get calcium back. Sometimes the struggle gets out of hand. Take the Irish giant deer, Megalocharis giganteus. Their antlers could span over 3 meters and weigh more than 30 kilograms, truly unmatched in size and relative body proportion. They went extinct about 7,700 years ago. Humans played a part, but those massive antlers likely didn't help. Today, even-toed ungulates are the undisputed kings of large land herbivores, thriving in the wild and inside human enclosures alike. Cattle even rank as the heaviest animals by total biomass on Earth. So the peaceful scene of cows and sheep grazing will continue on this planet for a long, long time. Honestly, even-toed ungulates are one of the most surprising and laid-back animal groups out there. While other herbivores focus all their energy on eating or escaping, even-toed ungulates seem mostly obsessed with fighting. Usually, when animals develop extravagant appendages, it means their evolution is hitting a dead end. But even-toed ungulates have completely trampled that rule underfoot. While other animals struggle just to survive, even-toed ungulates have the leisure to pull off all sorts of crazy tricks. They truly are the coolest evolutionary rebels.
Hello.